I'll take point. Stay close, everyone.
We're right behind you, boss.
Gonna miss this festering boil on the ass end of the comet.
Where are we going?
Don't worry, Jim. Just stay with me. It'll be fine.
My new vacation home.
Your idea of heaven, eh, Sturgis? Could be some good salvage in there. I think we're close. Glad you decided to come with us. I should have listened to Mama Murphy all along. Pretty nice place she's found for us. I think we could settle down here. Make it a place to call home. What do you think?
So, do you believe in these visions she has?
I didn't used to, but how did she know about this place? I think she has some kind of a gift. Best not to ignore it. I mean, look at this place. I really think this could be what we've been looking for.
I don't know. It's strange being back here.
What do you mean? You used to live here or something?
Yeah. Before the war. Before everything was ruined.
What do you mean? Before what war? Are you saying...
I lived here over 200 years ago. I was frozen or something for most of it. Just woke up a little while ago.
Damn. Like one of those old pre-war ghouls. You say you were frozen. Anybody else make it out with you?
My son. Somebody took him away while I was still trapped. I've been looking for him.
Damn. I'm sorry. I hope you find him. Let me know if there's any way I can help. Anyway, I am glad you're here. And I hope you don't mind, but I've got another favor to ask. I've had word from a settlement asking for help. They're still hoping there are Minutemen out there, somewhere. The only chance to start rebuilding the Minutemen is to show people that they can count on us when they need us. Trouble is, I've got my hands full here. Do you think you could go help out the settlement?
I'd be glad to help.
That's fantastic. The Minutemen could use more people like you. By the way, if you want to help out around here at all, talk to Sturgis. I'm sure he'd be glad for all the help he can get.
Was Tex Beneke. a word, or several, from our sponsors. Fallon's Basement, providing top-of-the-line fashion to Diamond City for over 10 generations. Next is some Cole Porter.
Rewound the clock since the Puritans got the shock when they landed on Plymouth Rock. If today any shock they should try to stem, instead of landing on Plymouth Rock would land on them. In olden days, a glimpse of stocking was looked on as something shocking, but now God knows anything goes. Reformers who once used better words now only use four letter words, writing prose. Anything goes. If driving fast cars you like, if low bars you like, if old kids you like, if fair limbs you like, if May West you like, or me undressed you like, why nobody will oppose. When every night the set that's smart is intruding and nudist parties in studio, anything goes. When Mrs. Ned McLean, God bless her, can get Russian red to yes, then I suppose anything goes. When Rockefeller still can hoard enough money to let Matt Gordon produce his show,
hand over the goods.
Anything goes.
I ain't giving you boys and shilling
the world
bushes
has gone
anything.
Mad today.
Do you know what that junk has done to my baby?
Whoa.
Black
white
easy today, and day's night today, and that gent today, you gave a cent today, once had several.
You stop waving that gun in my face, or it's gonna involve me.
That's it. You're dead. You crossed
his black baby glow. Anything goes. When Sam Goldwyn can, with great conviction, instruct Anna's man in diction, then Anna shows. Anything goes. When you hear that lady mental standing up, now does a handspring landing up on her toes. Anything goes. Just think of those shots you got, and those knocks you got, and those bruises you got from
the hey there, huh? You got, and those I can't wait to got, see the crow's feet on that scumbag. Here, this is for you. Now, if you ever need to trade, my shop's open.
Can broadcast a bed from Simmons called Frank Malone.
You got things covered from here?
Yeah. It's gonna take my son a while to get off the chems, but we'll make it. We always do. Now, let's get back to business. You need anything for the road?
I'll think about it.
Like a rabbit, fly like a bee. No matter what you do, you'll never get away from me. Because I'm right behind you, baby. Right behind you, baby. Well, I'm right behind you, baby, and you'll never get away from me. Well, you can make up your face, now you'll have. No matter what you do, turn around and up and down. Because I'm right behind you, baby. Right behind you, baby. Well, I'm right behind you, baby, and you'll never know. Well, you can go through the east, go through the west, the north and the south, and all the rest. You can bop at the heart, but go across the floor. No matter what you do, you'll never get it anymore. Well, you can fly through the clouds, sail on the sea. No matter what you do, you'll never get away from me. Because I'm right behind you, baby. I'm right behind you, baby. I'm right behind you, baby.
clouds, sail on the sea. No matter what you do, you'll never get away from me. Because I'm right behind you, baby. I'm right behind you, baby. Yeah, I'm right behind you, baby, and you're never gonna get away. Well, I'm right behind you, baby, and you're never gonna get away. Let's go now. Well, I'm right behind you, baby, and you're never gonna get away.
When Madame Pompadour was on a ballroom floor, said all the gentlemen obviously, the madam has the cutest personality. And think of all the books about Du Barry's looks. What was it made of? A toast of Paris. She had a well-developed personality.
What did Romeo, Julie and Juliet, or Piero in Pierrette, or Jupiter in Juno?
You know. And when Salome danced and had the boys entranced, no doubt it must have been easy to see that she knew how to use her personality.
Well, and have to sit on a box settee. I bet she's got a perfect personality. A girl can get somewhere in spite of stringy hair, or even just a bit foot at the knee. She can show up.
Let's go beer.
Personality.
Why certain girls off at certain things, like stable clothes and wedding rings, on men who wear that's right.
That's right. So don't you say I'm smart and have the kindest heart. Oh, what a wonderful sister I'd be.
Just tell me how you like my
personality.
Baby, you've got the cutest
personality.
That was Personality by Johnny Mercer. Here's a thing. A sort of a note, I guess, from a sponsor here in Diamond City, and I'll just read it. Feeling tired, need a pick-me-up, visit Chemicare and get a prescription today. A balanced life through chemistry. This next song, it's, well, it's 60 Minute Man, and oh boy! I just,
if you don't believe I'm all out. say, come again, take my hand. When I let you go, you'll cry, oh yes, he's a 60-minute man. There'll be 15 minutes of kissing. Then you'll have a few more shots. There'll be 50 minutes of pleasing, 50 minutes of pleasing, 50 minutes of blowing my top. Old man needs treating you right. Come up and see old dad. I'll rock 'em, roll 'em all night long. I'm a 60-minute man.
Call
the love and then I rock and roll all night long. I'm a 60-minute man. 60-minute
man.
They call me
love and then
I rock and roll them all night long. I'm a 60-minute man. There'll be 15 minutes of kissing.
Then you holler, please don't stop.
There'll be 50 minutes for teasing, and 50 minutes of squeezing, and 50 minutes of
going. What do you mean you can't open the gate? Stop playing around, Danny. I'm standing out in the open here for crying out loud.
I got orders not to let you in, Miss Piper. I'm sorry. I'm just doing my job.
Ooh, just doing your job. Protecting Diamond City means keeping me out, is that it? Oh, look, it's the scary reporter. Boop.
I'm sorry, but Mayor McDonough's really steamed, Piper. Saying that article you wrote was all lies. The whole city's in a tizzy.
You open this gate right now, Danny Sullivan. I live here. You can't just lock me out. Damn it, Danny. Open up! You. You want into Diamond City, right?
What? Who are you?
Shh. Play along. What's that? You said you're a traitor up from Quincy? You have enough supplies to keep the general store stocked for a whole month? You hear that, Danny? You gonna open the gate and let us in, or are you gonna be the one talking to crazy Myrna about losing out on all the supply?
Jeez, all right. No need to make it personal, Piper. Give me a minute.
Better head inside quick before old Danny catches on to the bluff.
You first.
Wouldn't have it any other way.
Piper, who let you back inside? I told Sullivan to keep that gate shut. You devious, rabble-rousing slanderer. The level of dishonesty in that paper of yours. I'll have that printer scrapped for parts.
Ooh, that a statement, Mr. McDonough? Tyrant mayor shuts down the press. Why don't we ask the newcomer? You support the news? Because the mayor's threatened to throw free speech in the dumpster.
What newspaper are you talking about?
Mine. Public Occurrences. And we're the hard look at the truth. So are you with us or not?
Always believed in freedom of the press.
Oh, I didn't mean to bring you into this argument, good sir. No. No, no. You look like Diamond City material. Welcome to the great green jewel of the Commonwealth. Safe, happy, a fine place to come. Spend your money. Settle down. Don't let this muckraker here tell you otherwise, all right?
Whatever. I'm not going to be here long.
Another see-no-evil type. You'll fit in just fine with all the inept guards.
Now, was there anything particular you came to our city for?
I'm trying to find someone.
Trying to find someone? Who?
An infant boy. Kidnapped.
Did you say kidnapped? Well, McDonough, Diamond City Security gonna investigate this? How about all the other kidnapping reports you've been...
Don't listen to her. Well, I'm afraid that our security team can't follow every case that comes through. I'm confident that you can find help here. Diamond City has every conceivable service known to man. One of our great citizens can surely find the time to help you.
Well, sure. And a mayor of a great city must know everyone. Who can help me?
I'm sorry, I don't have time for any more questions. I'm a busy man. Enjoy your stay in our fair city.
This is ridiculous. Diamond City Security can't spare one officer to help. I want the truth, McDonough. What's the real reason security never investigates any cases?
I've had enough of this, Piper. From now on, consider you and that little sister of yours on notice.
Yeah, keep talking, McDonough. That's all you're good for. A big Diamond City welcome from the mayor. You feel honored yet? Look, I gotta go get settled in, but, stop by my office later. I have an idea for an article you'd be perfect for.
Head on inside.
Anyone is one of those things. It's that secretary
of his. Supposed to talk to people, I don't know.
And her perfect hair.
Mm-hmm.
The mayor's secretary. Come on, Ma. I cut her hair myself, and I know human hair.
Nani, she must go.
Do yourself a favor and just say yes. It's all he understands.
Tell me a joke.
Nani, she must go.
Tell me a joke.
Nani, she must go.
Tell me a joke.
Nani shimasuka?
Yes?
Piper! You know what you're looking for?
Newcomer, huh? Talk to Abbott at the wall, if you want a history lesson.
Institute has to have enemies, right?
What? You mean the railroad? That's a fairy tale.
I told you your luck wouldn't last forever. His ties. Oh, Nick. The bills. Huh. Forget the bills. The photographs. He never did photograph well.
Something wrong?
Another stray coming in from the rain. Afraid you're too late. Office is closed.
I know you must be busy, but I won't take much of your time, miss. It's important.
You don't get it. The detective, he's gone. Missing.
Picture on milk carton time?
If only it was that simple, right? Nick disappeared working a case. Skinny Malone's gang had kidnapped a young woman, and he tracked them down to their hideout in Park Street Station. There's an old vault down there they use as a base. I told Nick he was walking into a trap, but he just smiled and walked out the door like he always does.
I'll find him. You have my word.
Thank you. Nick should be easy to spot. He's always wearing that old hat and trench coat getup. Please, hurry.
The sun gone shining.
your love. I wake up in the morning and I wonder.
Don't move, Sin. What have you done with the real Riley? Where's my brother?
I swear I'm not a Sin. Don't shoot, for God's sakes, we're family. I
can't. Put the gun down now.
He's a Sin. He'll kill us all.
Kyle, no!
Okay, show's over. There are no Sins in Diamond City.
Why
hear me?
Does
you
my
folks
heart
in your damn
go on pleading? Why do these eyes of mine cry? Don't they know it's the end of the world? It ended when you say goodbye. Why does my heart go on beating? Why do these eyes of mine cry? Don't they know it's the end of the world? It ended when you said goodbye.
Well, I don't know, but I've been told uranium ore's worth more than gold. Sold my cad, I bought me a Jeep, I got that bug, and I can't sleep.
Uranium fever has come and got me down. Uranium fever is spreading all around.
With a Geiger counter in my hand,
I'm going out to take me some government land.
Uranium fever has come and got me down.
Well, I had a talk with the AEC, and they brought out some maps that looked good to me. And one showed me a spot he said he knowed, so I straddled my Jeep and headed down the road. I reckon I drove about 100 miles down a bumpy road out through the wilds, when all of a sudden I bounced a stop at the foot of a mountain, didn't have no top.
Uranium fever has done and got me down. Uranium fever is spreading all around.
With a Geiger counter in my hand,
I'm going out to stake me some government land.
Uranium fever has done and got me down.
Well, I took the Geiger and I started to climb right up to the top where I thought I'd find a hunk of rock that'd make it click just like I'd ripped out burning pick. On the second day, I made the top, and I'm telling you, Steve, I was ready to stop. The only clicking that I heard that day was the bones in my back that had gone astray.
Uranium fever has done and got me down. Uranium fever, it's spreading all around.
With a Geiger counter in my hand,
I'm going out to stay in the government land.
Uranium fever has done and got me down.
Well, you pack up your things, you head out again into some unknown spot where nobody's been. You reach the spot where your fortune lies. You find it's been staked by 17 other guys. Well, I ain't kidding, I ain't gonna quit. That bug's done caught me and I've been bit. So with a Geiger counter and a pick in my hand, I'll keep right on staking that government land.
Uranium fever has done and got me down. Uranium fever is spreading all around.
With a Geiger counter in my hand,
I'm going out to stake me some government land.
Uranium fever has done and got me down.
They don't even know my name. They call me the Wanderer. Yeah, the Wanderer. I roam around, 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 around. Oh, well, there's Flo on my left arm, and there's Mary on my right. And Janie is the girl, well, that I'll be with tonight. And when she asks me who is my love the best, I'll take her and I know Rosie on my watches, cause I'm a wanderer. Yeah, a wanderer.
No way I could pick this.
Diamond City Radio. If you're listening at all, I mean. The five stars are next, singing about a lady. I guess maybe I don't like her. I mean, that would just create workplace tension.
Don't think I can pick this.
Here's the five stars.
Got a dog. I love her so. Nothing else like her anywhere you go. Man, she's anything but calm. Regular pint size atom bomb.
Atom bomb, baby, little atom bomb. I want her in my wigwam. She's just the way I want her to be. A million times hotter than TNT.
Atom bomb, baby, boy, she can start one of those chain reactions in my heart. A big explosion, big and loud, mushrooms me right up on a cloud.
Atom bomb, baby, little atom bomb. I want her in my wigwam. She's just the way I want her to be. A million times hotter than TNT. Bum, Leada, bum, Leada, bum, Leada, bum.
Atom bomb, baby, sweet as a plum. Carries more wallop than uranium. When she kisses, there's no hitch. 0 hour, she turns on the switch.
Atom bomb, baby, little atom bomb. I want her in my big bomb. She's just the way I want her to be. A million times hotter than TNT. Atom bomb, baby, little atom bomb. I want her in my wigwam. She's just the way I want her to be. A million times hotter than TNT.
Excellent.
69 rocket, 69.
With a sweet man like you, we could have such a wonderful time.
Rocket 69, rocket 69.
You'll have to hold tight, Bob, a while ago went to my speed.
Rocket 69, rocket 69.
Well, you'll have to hold tight, Bob, a while ago went to my speed.
Rocket.
Pretty good. gonna dig. Money, money, honey, the kind you fold. Money, money, honey, rock and roll. Break it in, fade it up like hay. Have a rock and roll time to blow it all away. Well, I can see me now in my long Cadillac. Engines in the middle, spare wheel on the back. Man, don't you know it'd be hard to stop when I find that big uranium rock. Money, money, honey, money, money, break it in, break it up like hey. Yes, that's me in my long Cadillac. We're heading down the road and I ain't coming back. Gonna make me stop when I find that big rock. Money, money, honey, the kind of gold. Money, money, honey,
why you make things so loud?
Drink it in, drink it up like hay. Have a rocking good time and throw it all away.
Hope you enjoyed that song by Warren Smith, because I can't take it back. This is Diamond City Radio, and I'm, you know, this is me, Travis.
So I got a question.
Anyway.
Why the hell would anyone build a vault out of a subway station?
Coal.
This place is like the opposite of airtight.
Because they weren't planning to use it, you moron. We used to pull this kind of gun all the time back before the war. Get a bunch of you. Who's there? Just dead! You pay for that!
RFK. And we've often rewound the clock since the Puritans got the shock when they landed on Plymouth Rock. If today any shock they should try to stem, instead of landing on Plymouth Rock would land on them. In
wait.
Olden days, a glimpse of shocking wasn't a song of something shocking, but now God knows anything goes. Good offers to who once knew better words, now only use four-letter words, writing prose.
I got the drop on it.
Anything goes. Driving fast cars, like to go walk, you like to hold him, you like to bear this, you like to may west, you like for me unrest, you like why nobody will oppose. When every night, the set and smart is intruding, and new disport is in studio. Anything goes. When Mrs. Ned McLean, God bless her, can get Russian red to yes, then I suppose. Anything goes. When Rockefeller still can hoard enough money to let Max Gordon produce his show. Anything goes. The world has gone mad today, and good's bad today, and black's white today, and day's night today, and that gent today, you gave a cent today, once had several chateaus.
So
when folks
just
who still
to
can
admire.
Ride it, it is out and the milks and witness lack baby clothes. Anything goes. When Sam Goldwyn can with great conviction instruct Anna stand in diction, then Anna shows. Anything goes. When you hear that lady mental standing up, now does a handspring landing up on
now?
Her toes.
Feeling hungry?
Anything goes.
Keep talking.
Just think of those shots you got.
Meathead. It'll give Skinny Malone more time to think about how he's gonna bump you off.
Don't give me that crap, Valentine. You know nothing, you got nothing.
Really? I saw him writing your name down in that black book of his. Lousy, cheating card shark, I think were his exact words. Then he struck the name across 3 times.
3 strikes? In the black book? But I never... Oh, no. I gotta smooth this over, fast.
What? Oh, knucklehead! Hey, you! I know who you are, but we got 3 minutes before they realize muscles for brains ain't coming back. Get this door open!
You gotta hack that terminal to open up this door.
Perfect.
Ah, my knight in shining armor. Question is, why does he come all this way, risk life and limb, for an old private eye?
I need you to find someone, but it's complicated. I don't exactly know where they could be or how long they've been gone.
Well, I've done jobs with less. Somehow nice and simple never makes it onto the menu in my world. I've been cooped up in here for weeks. Turns out the runaway daughter I came here to find wasn't kidnapped. She's Skinny Malone's new flame. And she's got a mean streak. Anyway, you got troubles, and I'm glad to help. But now ain't the time. Let's blow this joint. Then we'll talk. Malone's crew here used to be small time. Muscled out of the old neighborhood by bigger players. Until they found this place. Don't know what happened to the previous owners, but they're not exactly around to charge rent. An empty vault. Perfect hideout.
Hold up. I hear some of them coming. There they are. How do you want to play this?
His only job is to check on the prisoner. Why does that take so fucking long, huh? Hey, Dino! Quit razzing that detective and get down here! Where the heck is he?
Door's on the fritz. Let me see if I can get it open. Almost got... There we are. Hell of a lot easier to do when the lock isn't on the other side.
The fix is in!
Why do you walk away?
What?
Jumpy.
What the?
More stairs? Who
built this damn vault? A fitness instructor? Dangerous.
Only opens with a key.
Another locked door. Shouldn't be too hard. Okay, I got it. But I hear big fat footsteps on the other side. Once we step through this door, get ready for anything.
Nicky, what are you doing? You're coming to my house? Shoot up my guys? You have any idea how much this is gonna set me back?
I wouldn't be here if it weren't for your two-timing dame, Skinny. You ought to tell her to write home more often.
Oh, poor little Valentine. Ashamed you got beat up by a girl. I'll just run back home to Daddy, shall I?
Should've left it alone, Nikki. This ain't the old neighborhood. In this vault, I'm king of the castle. You hear me? And I ain't letting...
Well, so much for Skinny Malone. Think he's lighter or heavier with all those holes in him. Well, the bullets probably add a few ounces. Good night, sweet prince. Here's to all the old days. It's gonna be an awkward conversation with Darla's parents when I tell them their daughter bit the big one. Well, at least the case is closed. Let's get out of here. There's a service ladder that should take us right to the surface. That Commonwealth sky. Never thought anything so naturally ominous could end up looking so inviting. Thanks for getting me out. How did you know where to find?
Your secretary, Ellie. She sent me.
She did? I should give her a raise. Now, you mentioned something about a missing person. No trace of where they've gone. I want you to come to my office in Diamond City. Give me all the details. Besides, I think you've earned a chance to sit down and clear your head.
I'll meet you there.
See you in Diamond City.